Welcome back, everybody. Today is another math review with Teacher Reg. For the past days, we have been learning all about graph. And we have learned that it teaches us to group, compare, count, organize, and analyze data. We also learned that there are three important parts of a graph. The first one is the title. The second one is all about the data. And the third one is all about the categories, groups, or labels. This is a vertical bar graph. A few days ago, we have learned another kind of bar graph. And it looks just like this and this. Do you still remember what we call this kind of graph? Can you recall? Yes, we call this horizontal bar graph. Let's take a look at this picture. On the top part, we have the vertical bar graph, while at the bottom part, we have the horizontal bar graph. These two graphs are not really different from each other. You see, both of them have the categories, groups, or labels, and both of them also have data for us to analyze and study. Now, what's different? Well, let's take a closer look. For the vertical bar graph, when we look at the data, we would notice that the data looks like a tall building. So from the bottom, we stack going up. While when we take a closer look at the horizontal bar graph, the data doesn't look like buildings anymore. Instead, it looks like a road that is short, and a row that is long. Whenever we analyze a horizontal bar graph data, our eyes move from left to right to study or analyze it. Take a look at this one. Can you tell me if this graph is a vertical bar graph or a horizontal bar graph? The correct answer is, yes, it is a vertical bar graph. How about this one? Is this a vertical bar graph or a horizontal bar graph? What is your guess? The correct answer is horizontal bar graph. Look at this one. Is this an example of a bar graph? Vertical, horizontal bar graph? No, this is not a bar graph because we call this kind of graph picture graph or pictogram. So, how is the picture graph different from a bar graph? Let me tell you. A picture graph usually uses drawings or symbols in the data. And aside from that, a picture graph also has a key that will tell us the value of each drawing or symbol. Using the key, we would know if we need to count it by ones, by twos, by fives, and so on and so forth. All eyes on this picture graph. The title is all about class pets, and the key says a pet is equal to one student, which means we're going to count by ones. Count as it is. Question number one. How many students own a dog? Everybody, let's focus on the dog data and let's start counting. The correct answer is 6. Let's try another one. How many students own a hamster? Looking eyes. What's your guess? The correct answer is 4. Now let's try another one. Are there more students who own a fish than a cat? Yes or no? So this time we're going to compare. Look at the fish data and look at the cat data. What is the answer? The correct answer is no. Why? Because if you're going to look at the data, you would realize that there are more students who own a cat than a fish. We are going to review more about picture graph next time. And that's it for today. Thank you very much and I'll see you again. Bye!